we are going to begin finding proportions above or below a particular z-score. Many students find this a bit tricky, so I'd like to explain how to think through these types of problems. The first thing you need to know is that because half of the scores are below the mean, and half of the scores are above the mean, the probability of a score being below or above the mean is p equals 0.5000, or 0.5. The second thing to remember is that our z table tells us the proportion of scores between the mean and a particular z score. With these two bits of information, we can use addition or subtraction to find the proportion of any part of the bell curve. Let's begin by tackling the problem of what proportion of scores are below z equals positive 1.00. Notice that I've put a dotted line at z equals positive 1.00. We want to find the proportion of scores at or below this point. This whole section of the bell curve actually comprises two things. First, it includes the scores from the mean to z equals positive 1.00. This we could find from our z table. The proportion is 0.3413. Second, this section of the bell curve includes all of the scores below the mean. We know that this proportion is 0.5, or half of the scores. By adding these two portions together, we can determine the whole. Adding 0.3413 to 0.5 equals 0.8413. But what if our task involved finding a small portion of the bell curve? Say, we want to know what proportion of scores are below z equals negative 1.25. This is only a small part of the normal curve, but we can use the same techniques to figure it out. First, we can go to the z table and find the proportion of scores from the mean to negative 1.25. That value is 0.3944. We know that half of the scores are below the mean, a proportion of 0.5, so we need the remainder. We subtract our z value from 0.5 to get the answer. 0.5000 minus 0.3944 equals 0.1056. Using what we know, let's find the proportion of scores above or below these z-scores. For each of these examples, it might help to draw a normal curve to see what part you're trying to find. In this case, I will show you the proportion on the normal curve below. As in the previous examples, I will ask the question and then provide the answer. You should pause the video while you work on the example on your own. So what proportion of the scores are below z equals positive 1.00? It's a 0.8413. This is the example that we did just a moment ago, so go back and review that if you still have any questions. Now it's your turn to try. What proportion of the scores are above a z of negative 0.50? 0.6915. What proportion of the scores are above a negative 1.50? 0.9332. What proportion of scores are below a positive 0.67? 0.7486. How about above 0.80? 0.2119. Below negative 2.00. 0.0228. Below a negative 1.01. 0.1562. And above, positive 2.00, 0.0228. Notice that the proportion of scores above a positive 2.00 is exactly the same size as the proportion of scores below a negative 2.00. We can even apply these skills to our example about the three guys who took the attractiveness test. And of course, a proportion can be converted to a percentage by moving the decimal two places to the right. So Shifty, with his z of negative 2.50, is more attractive than 0.62% of all men. Not 62%, 0.62%, less than 1%. Now Mickey, with his z of a positive 0.50, is more attractive than 69.15% of all men. And Antonio, with his z of positive 3.00, is more attractive than 99.87% of all men. Great. Now we're going to use these skills in a new way. So far, I've just been giving you the z-scores. Next, we're going to compute z-scores ourselves from raw data and then figure out the proportion below the normal curve.